Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will study about daisy chaining method. So what happens in this daisy chaining method? As we know that there are many input-output devices which are connected to the computer. And each of the device can send interrupt request. So there are possibilities that a CPU receives more than one interrupt requests from the input-output devices. Now CPU has to decide which interrupt request is to be serviced first. Now what happens? In that case, priority has to be established among the input-output devices so that the device which has the highest priority, then its interrupt request should be serviced first. So daisy chaining method is a method for establishing the priority among the input-output devices on the basis of their position. In this case, what happens? All the devices are connected serially, and the device which is at first position, it has highest priority, and the device which is at second position, it has second highest priority, and the device which is at last position, it has lowest priority. So in this, see this diagram. In this, these devices are connected serially, and priority of the devices is based on their position, and each device has priority in input. PI means priority in, and each device has priority out. PO output, priority out output, priority in input. So here there is a common interrupt request line among all these devices. So this interrupt request line is common to all devices. So whenever the CPU receives interrupt requests, it responds by enabling its interrupt acknowledge line. When this interrupt acknowledge line is enabled, it means it has sent an interrupt acknowledgement signal on this line. So first that signal is received by first device, right? Now if this device does not have any interrupt request, then what it does, it will pass that interrupt acknowledgement signal to the second device through priority out output, right? If it places one at priority out output, then it means that interrupt acknowledgement signal has been passed to second device. But if device 1 has some interrupt request, then it will not pass that interrupt acknowledgement signal to device 2, right? Because it has some interrupt request, so it will get its interrupt request serviced first. So what it does, it will place its interrupt vector address into the data bus for the CPU, which is used during the interrupt cycle. And priority out output, at PO output, it places 0, right? When it places 0, then it means it has blocked the interrupt acknowledgement signal. It has not passed the interrupt acknowledgement signal to the second device, right? So in this case, what happened? This first device will get the chance first, right? After that, if suppose device 1 has passed that interrupt acknowledgement signal to second device, now the second device has a chance to get its interrupt request serviced, right? So in this way, the priority is maintained on the basis of positions, because first of all, the device which is at first position, it will get a chance to get its interrupt request serviced, then the second device, then the third device, and so on. So this is the way how the priority is maintained among the devices in daisy chaining method.